Welcome to Wisdom Era, the biggest learning platform. In this class, you will be able to learn Gupta Empire and the reigns of Shatavahana and Kushana's empire rose Gupta Empire. Gupta Empire stretched everywhere at the time of Sri Gupta and the most famous ruler of Gupta dynasty. Sri, the founder of Gupta dynasty was Sri Gupta. Sri Gupta extended his empire everywhere by acquiring different land areas. And the most famous king of this dynasty was Chandragupta I. Chandragupta I had the title of Maharajadiraja. He was the first important king of this dynasty. Lichavi princess from Nepal, which strengthened his political position. And later, he implemented various kinds of policies in the printing of different coins, in the minting of different coins. The ruler of considerable importance because he started the Gupta era in AD 319 to 20, which marked the very important historical event. He introduced very different inscriptions. Later, Samudragupta had the power of Gupta dynasty. The Gupta kingdom was enlarged enormously by Chandragupta, his son and successor Samudragupta. Samudragupta, he was the most prominent king and he implemented various kinds of military strategies and different inscriptions introduced by Samudragupta. The foremost one, what you are seeing, Allahabad inscription. So the Allahabad pillar inscription contains a long list of states, kings and tribes which were conquered and brought under various rulers. And Samudragupta performed the Ashwamedha sacrifice. Ashwamedha Yaga made by Chandragupta. Chandragupta implemented various policies. Later, Samudragupta had the power. The Napoleon of India, he had the title because of his military strategies. Later, Chandragupta II came to be power, succeeded by his son Chandragupta II, Vikramaditya. Means after Chandragupta II, Vikramaditya came to be power. What you are observing, the different coins, the coins were most important sources to know different qualities. Reign of Chandragupta II saw the highest peak of the Gupta Empire, inherited the military genius of his father and extended the Gupta Empire. So the Gupta Empire, what you are seeing, the battle scenes, means so many people, they fought with many rulers. When we come to the matrimonial alliances, strength the political power to married different kinds of peoples with neighboring countries. He gave his daughter Prabhavati in marriage and they maintained a cordial relationship with another rulers, like the rulers of Nanda dynasty. When the Vakatas prince died, she managed the affairs of kingdom, helped the official sent her father Chandragupta. Chandragupta, Samudragupta and many people, they were the royal patronage and the most important kings. Chandragupta exercised indirect control over the Venkata kingdom and he conquered different kinds of dynasties, like what you are seeing, Mauryas, late Guptas, Kakatiyas and so on. Later Kumaragupta came to be power. So Kumaragupta, he was the successor of Chandragupta II. You keep it in your mind, this is very important one. Then after Kumaragupta, many rulers ruled Gupta dynasty. Many rulers, they attended different kinds of cordial relationship in another country. They laid the foundation of the Nalanda dynasty. It was the very important incident took place at the time of a powerful ruler of Guptas. Later, Guptas laid the foundation for art, architecture, war and different battles and different strategies they were adopted. He fought successfully against the Hunas and saved their empire. So later, Skandagupta, he was the last great ruler of Gupta dynasty. Skandagupta's death, many of his successors like Purugupta and another people came to be power. Later, Purugupta and another people, Gupta dynasty had been declined due to several policies. When we come to the Gupta administration, Gupta had the power of administration by adopting various policies. Like, provinces in Gupta's period were known as Buktis and provincial governors, Uparikas. Close contact with provincial administration through a class of officials called Kumaratyas and Ayuktas. The provinces were divided into districts, Vishayas under charge of different rulers. The foreign affairs ministers known as Sandhivigraha. Sandhivigraha was called as foreign minister. Later, religion and social culture of Guptas. Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudras were existed during the time of Guptas. Brahmins reigned supreme during Gupta period, had two branches mainly, Vaishnavism and Shaivism. So Vaishnavism and Shaivism, that was the very important system at the time of society of Gupta period. So art and culture, when we come to art and culture, Gupta age is called golden age of India in field of art, science and literature. See what you are seeing, the glory of Gupta dynasty, the wonderful gift. Like Delhi Iron Pillar, 700 feet Buddha statue, Diograph temple, and what you are observing, Buddha idol. They are given the many contribution of Gupta dynasty, like paint, art, architecture, and so on. So later, literature. Literature is the most prominent system. Sanskrit became primary language in Gupta period. Means those were written in the Sanskrit language. Sanskrit was the foremost language during that time. Finally, editing of the Ramayana and Mahabharata took place in Gupta period. Gupta period. Like, thank you one and all. In next class, we'll discuss remaining.